In today's video, I am going to explain anatomy of muscles that do posterior tilt of pelvis. Posterior tilt, which is this kind of movement of pelvis. So it's kind of you tuck your coccyx and sacrum this way. In result, your lumbar gets flat. Pelvis goes this way, and lumbar gets flattened. I will explain one by one. So this is posterior view. I will explain this muscle first. This is gluteus maximus. Gluteus maximus. It attaches to pelvis, sacrum, and coccyx. It attaches to posterior part of pelvis. And this is profile view. Imagine this is gluteus maximus. When this muscle contracts this way, that brings pelvis to posterior tilt. Simple enough, right? Then next muscle is, well, kind of muscle groups is these guys, okay? These muscle groups is hamstrings. There are three muscles in hamstrings, right? Biceps femoris, semitendinosus, and semimembranosus. These three muscles together, it is called hamstrings, correct? Let's go back to profile view again. Hamstrings attaches to pelvis. Let's change picture. Hamstrings attaches to ischial tuberosity, right here. Then let's change picture. See? Imagine there is pelvis here. It is about here, right? This is ischial tuberosity. Imagine hamstrings attach here like this. Then when hamstrings pulls ischial tuberosity this way, then pelvis goes to posterior tilt. Let's check other picture. See? This is hamstrings. Imagine this is ischial tuberosity. Hamstrings pulls ischial tuberosity this way. Thus, in result, pelvis goes to posterior tilt, right? These two muscle groups, I mean, gluteus maximus and hamstrings, are strong muscles for posterior tilt. They are literally big. Like, gluteus maximus is the biggest muscle in human body, and hamstrings is also huge muscle. Look at its size. It's humongous, right? No wonder these two muscles are strong for posterior tilt. Gluteus maximus and hamstrings are hip extensor. They move hip this way. But if hip joint is stabilized, gluteus maximus and hamstrings can pull pelvis this way. Thus, posterior tilt happens. Well then, let's go to next muscle. Next muscle is this one. This is gluteus medius. Gluteus medius. And posterior fiber of this muscle, let's say this can bring pelvis to posterior tilt. Let's divide gluteus medius to two parts. This is posterior fiber. Do you remember? Hip extensor is also pelvic posterior tilt muscle. Yes, indeed. Gluteus medius posterior fiber can do extension. By the way, anterior fiber is for flexion and anterior tilt. This muscle is very important for pelvic movement and hip movement. Deep to gluteus medius, there is one more gluteal muscle, that is gluteus minimus. Gluteus minimus. Let's say there's gluteus minimus deep to gluteus medius, like this. You can also separate gluteus minimus to two parts. You can suggest that. Posterior fiber can do posterior tilt. I keep repeating, hip extensor is also pelvic posterior tilt muscle. Thus, gluteus minimus also can do hip extension, particularly posterior fiber. So gluteus medius and gluteus minimus can move pelvis and hip for numerous directions. They are so important. Basically, all gluteal muscles can do posterior tilt. Gluteus maximus, gluteus medius, and gluteus minimus. These are pretty much it for a hip joint muscle. However, core muscle also can do pelvic posterior tilt. That is this muscle. This is famous core muscle. This is rectus abdominis. Rectus abdominis. Main function of this muscle is trunk flexion. It's literally sit-up muscle. However, if rectus abdominis contracts to this way, this upper way, that can bring pelvis to this direction, kind of this movement. What is this? This is posterior tilt, right? This direction of contraction matters. Your back muscles can move pelvis either anterior tilt or posterior tilt. Which way is that? Imagine when your back muscle contracts to this way, that brings pelvis to anterior tilt. So core muscles also can rotate pelvis. Very important. Abdominal muscle moves pelvis to posterior tilt. Back muscle brings pelvis to anterior tilt. They are very, very important. Now, let me explain additional muscle groups. That is adductor muscle, particularly adductor magnus. Adductor magnus. Main function of this muscle is, of course, adduction. However, adductor magnus also can do hip extension. Hip extension, right? Do you remember? Hip extensor is also pelvic posterior tilt muscle, right? Thus, adductor magnus somehow can do posterior tilt of pelvis. You don't see this information from anatomy books. I haven't seen them. Let's say this is just my personal opinion. This is my hypothesis. Because adductor magnus can do extension, so no doubt this muscle can do posterior tilt. Basically, posterior tilt muscle is on posterior part of pelvis and hip. That makes sense. Imagine there are muscles. When these guys contract this way, this vector brings pelvis to posterior tilt. So in this video, I explained anatomy of muscles that do posterior tilt of pelvis. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.